What are we thinking for roles?
I'm doing camera.
So, you got...
You want me to do time?
You can, you want.
Can you switch to the court side view?
Yes.
You can actually.
I just got it.
You know what? This is what I think. I think you do the switcher and the time, and I can do the tilting.
Okay.
Do that work?
Yeah.
All right. Switch spots with time.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Ask you! Ask you! No, no, because I'm not.
You don't have a lot of slack.
Just have Shadid do the thing. You know how I just want. Are we live?
Yeah,
yes.
But, okay. What about me switching this?
I can
do it.
Yeah, if you know how to do it.
Which one should I switch between?
Based off the camera views.
I'll let you handle that part.
Okay.
So we got. Oh, what's it? What's this mean?
Okay.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, I know. Because you got it.
Oh, no, it's in your hand. So
yeah,
so.
I know.
So you just got to have that.
I yeah, I know.
Did you get it?
Yeah. Hey, you didn't work on your Instagram story, did you?
Not too much.
Kevin, get ready.
You guys need to be ready.
There's no lead on
it. Tony? Yeah. All right, I'm ready.
Okay.
Are we live?
Yes, you are live.
3, 2,
all right, you ready? All right,
side, they're such a dangerous team. And that's one thing we've seen in the past, so keep an eye on that. that if they're able to win the first quarter. Evan Barra actually from up here, it looks like he stepped out of bounds. For all of those who might not know the college dodgeball format, we play where on the sideline, all you have to do is have one contact in bounds, and if you step out in one corner, you lift it up before it moves in bounds, so you couldn't have called out. And I think if you can switch, either one of us can switch.
Dodgeball leagues have different rules, so.
What exactly?
What constitutes a legal throw here? You can't just, so it's roll the ball.
Yeah. So what it's actually called is the LAZ, which is the legitimate attempt zone. So as you see, Dennis Sullivan came out to throw. That throw was within the LAZ because basically it was within a dive of the first player. So when you look at, as Grand Valley comes up to throw, that throw was low and it didn't hit anyone, but it was within either of those throws and you would go for it. So basically, forces you to make a throw that is legitimate and within reach of a player. You can't just waste the ball into the ground, roll it to the other side, throw it too high enough, and that's people are there. And that's one of the things that's good in mind with these two teams early in this game.
There's
two great catching teams where you are and throwing the ball up into there. Into the threat back. Guys, when it comes to reset throws and also just pushing in transition, which are two of the things that MSU is great at this game.
If anybody watched that Michigan State Saginaw game,
sidearm that it doesn't just stay up like that. Man, Stanko, easy pass.
In terms of player
position, 8-on-8, first point of the game here.
Nice up, Rollins.
First two in the queue for Grand Valley.
Oh, wow.
Long throw by Josh.
Good throw by Hill. For those who don't know, he tore his labor a year and a half ago.
Good!
Let's go,
Nolan!
Let's
go!
Set it
up, set it up!
Having ball control since they gave up the balls over has really played their way with it.
And Grand Valley historically is one of the most resilient teams in the country. If you lose a little bit of an advantage in momentum, they're able to come back usually and figure it out. They're good at adjusting strategy. This could turn into an MSU 1-0 lead, which I believe is what happens.
Side ready, dodgeball!
Let's go, GV, set it up! Pick your target!
Good! Got a mic down there on the floor, trying to make it as close to
being on the floor. Let's go, Roy!
Joining us here, this is the second game on our featured court earlier this week.
Set it up!
Grand Valley down to 6 players on their side, so they're 1 away from the 10th.
I'm impressed by how quickly they were able to set it up. That's one thing that separates a good team from a great team is communication at that level.
I like having the microphone down there in the court. I kind of hear their count. Can't hear them calling out plays, but it's kind of fun that it makes it feel like they're going to go.
Let's go, Nolan!
Nolan Stinko was looking at Rico to the court. Ben Traub almost caught him asleep in a nice block.
And right now we're looking at 6-on-6. First point of the day, and it's a low point. Okay, they call 96 out there.
I'll put MSU on the time clock now. So,
have any other balls on the other side. If I'm Grand Valley, I'm setting a team throw right here.
Hey, the count keeps going.
So it should have probably been balls over, but they didn't continue the count, it looks like. So.
Oh, wow.
And he has a fair complaint there. The counts on that play should have been even. They made a bit of a mistake, but still, that does not take away from the fact that Michigan State's made a couple big plays lately, two catches.
This is how good these two were.
It is a timeout.
And Barry Butler got the controllers in. They want to be aggressive and take this point.
Yeah, Jack Burley is a guy that maybe we haven't talked about that much, but he, last turn at GVSU, he was a guy that stepped up and looked at home on the court, even though it was his first year.
Overtime six.
All right, so
I'm out of the timeout here. Michigan State's going to move from your radio dial right to left here. Going to come up and set something up here.
Wow, Josh Hill survived. So we went for the captain for GVSU. Josh Hill in his first year as captain. He survives a two-ball team throw, and now they've got two balls on the side. It's going to be a reset play. Good reset and get back. The thing is, Michigan State has six left, so they are not on the 10th. They can use that to their advantage.
Oh, what a throw
by Nick Carroll. Unbelievable. Dunbar did not see that one coming. Now, after this, they'll be on the 10th.
So I believe Grand Valley called a timeout. So that's
smart move. As soon as the balls are released and on that side, you call a timeout. You keep them over there.
Awesome. Can you give me that water?
One says my name.
Thanks.
Dale.
A little confusion as to what happened there.
So
they maintained all the balls there. I'm not 100% sure what happened. We'll see if they adjust their throw. Josh Hill has been jumping every time they put a team throw on, so we'll see if someone puts one high.
Yeah, so that was tough because he did dodge both of those throws, but that's one of the more common ways to call a timeout is when there's a ball's over. MSU came up to throw after 5 seconds to pass. Brandon called a timeout, and now MSU has less time to make this team throw. So they only have 5 seconds. They're going to be a little bit more rushed. You're not going to have them making a team throw in as much of a rhythm. Two guys left for Grand Valley. Their captain, Josh Hill, and Tyler Peach.
Oh,
All right, so the counts are, so this is a very, very rare call. The counts were exactly even because of the ball's over and then one throw to GVSU. With the counts being exactly even, if they both are shot clock violations at the same time,
let's go,
it goes to even five and five. So each team has five balls, and that ended up working out pretty well for Grand Valley. And they've got a shot.
Yeah, this is big here. Now they have some ammo. If you make a team throw, they can also protect themselves. They've got state back down on the, on the 10 count,
and you have two veterans for GVSU against three rookies and Brent Weaver. So it's, I actually think it could go either way. Great block. Good throwing block by Weaver. He's so good at that. Oh, lucky. Down on the wire here, point number one, GVSU against MSU. Oh! He didn't care about the placement, he just threw it through his chest. Josh Hilbert tried. It is balls over. I mean, they had no ball on their side, and when Britt threw, it gives them one ball. They're both on the exact same 10 count.
Severn had a ball in his hand the whole time.
He's just got to have a little bit more awareness and understand that when the throw comes to your side, the counts are going to be even. So that count that he was hearing, he thought it was just for Green Valley, but it was for both teams. We got to... Looks like we have a timeout call.
Yeah, Grand Valley went ahead and called a timeout. I don't think they want to mess around. They want to get this point. Give Josh and Britt a little bit of extra time here, a little breather.
Yeah, so while we have a minute to breathe, what are your thoughts so far? One thing that I want to point out, and I know we mentioned him before, GVSU rookie Tyler Peach came up with that humongous catch down here when there was balls over and there was two players left for GVSU. He made a massive catch and that swung the whole game. And he's a guy that we talked to Grand Valley's leaders early on in the day, and they said, listen, I understand that Barry Butler's probably the MVP or the rookie of the year front runner at this point, and he stood out so much this year, but we think Tyler Peach should be in that discussion. They say he comes to practice an hour early and works with Ben Smart on his throws, and you can see he's gotten so much better at both his throwing and his catching abilities. So he's a guy that you've got to keep an eye on. He made a huge play there.
Stop the clock!
There should be 8 minutes and 12 seconds left.
So a little confusion, I'm not sure. What Michigan State did is they did what Green did. As soon as they threw, or right before he threw, they called a timeout, not letting him get set up. That might come
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing.
Oh, okay. Yep, so timeout was before the throws.
Yeah.
No.
What?
Is that balls have to be off the court to start?
Yeah, to start the point, they all have to be on the baseline. That's a rule. Yeah, I promise that's a rule. At least it used to be a rule when I was playing. It's not that good of a rule, but I'm just saying it's a rule.
Right now,
you just have to run up with the ball.
All right,
So a rule just dodgeball. Actually, we need to check and see if that's even a rule still. I know that back when I played at least.
Sorry about that. We need to get a little bleep button here.
So anyway, they got a ball zone, so they got two throws here. Same throw again.
Oh! Gets the ball right away and immediately starts running down Britt, but he took too long. I thought he took way too long to set up that throw.
But also, Skinner didn't grab a ball, and if I'm in that situation, I grab two balls in my hand.
I just get ready to charge.
Yeah, let him throw at me. I'll block it and I'll run him down in transition. But Skinner was confident in his catching.
And
to be fair, he had it right there. He should have made
it.
It hit
him in the chest. He got lucky. It bounced. Oh, I had a chance to make the catch again. He really missed. Haynes had nothing to like be able to try to throw a second one at him to move him. You don't see that.
But
what a heck of a first
point
here. We've only got 7:20 left in this half.
Twitter app is open.
Yeah,
actually
everything.
Grand Valley, it's always fun to win. That's all I'm saying.
This season has been, some of these games have been phenomenal.
Do you just want me to put the score, or do you want me to put anything else?
I cannot believe what I just saw.
Couldn't we be looking at another Game of the Year candidate?
Anything else?
Yeah, I mean, so far, yes.
Just a score, if you want anything before it.
He's probably saying, if I'm him, I'm saying, you're more valuable than one out for the other team. Smart already back in. So that's one thing is, for Grand Valley, they didn't get buried. They're two top players there. At least they didn't get buried. Ooh, I'm not sure if that one should have been.
Some tight windows again here from the refs. I like it, though. You can't just take the brand that the throw's going
to
come.
You need to make sure that the throw's legitimate, but at some point, it's too many stoppages. So there's a happy medium there, and I think the refs are doing a good job.
Do
we know the score back there?
No.
Do we know the score back there?
No. Smart back in, make it throw. One thing to think about right now, so uncharacteristic for Weekly to make that throw.
Smart throw! Take your charge!
has 5 minutes to go. 5:07. So both these teams, if you're not going to get a point here, you got to play smart and not give up a point. So play aggressive to an extent.
Yeah, I think we're always going to play aggressive until we know that they're going to run out of time.
Too many sloppy throws for Grand Valley. If I was Grand Valley's coach, I would like to see them get a little closer and make throws with a little bit higher percentage. Right now they're making low percentage throws.
Yeah, they're kind of playing a volume game, thinking we just need to throw and get killed.
They're playing quick. Yep. And right now the ball advantage is on their side. And you see Lico's angry over there, yelling at his team. You only have one ball on your side and two sitting right there. Grand Valley's got to execute a couple of hits here. Ooh, nice ball. And somebody's going to push up, grab that ball. If you're number 11 right there, you got to get a ball. And Haynes has one as well. They've got to step up and get an extra ball on their side. Just a showdown here. I don't know who's going to throw first. Nice hit by Antilla. Haynes stays alive. Wow. And you're looking at 3:50 left in the first half now.
Someone got Antilla on a late game.
Okay, it just barely took him. Yeah.
crazy to think how young this team is. They're kind of being.
They lose literally nobody, and they gain perhaps if you want to call it this, they get the best of both countries and take them back. You know what I mean? Like, they do not lose any key contributors, and they get their captain back.
And we're getting ahead of ourselves. This is a title contender this year.
Ooh!
In Green Valley, they're loose cannons right now, it looks like. It's not
too controlled,
but they are getting out. So I guess that's what matters. Makes a throw.
Control the ball. keep playing. We have Berlin and Sheila left for Michigan State. We have capable catchers. We've got a junior and two freshmen, but these two freshmen are not all Americans. If you have any of them,
they would both have my vote.
So Tony, let's talk about right now. You've got Michigan State took the first point, and it was a marathon of a point. That was, I mean, in this day and age, you don't see points taking 15 minutes anymore. And that one took over 15 minutes. And then after that, though, it's been all Grand Valley. Yes, these last 2 points have been close to start, but Grand Valley historically is such a good team. It is such a good team at closing out points, and they did that twice in a row here pretty quickly. We have 18:38 to go. It's still enough time for 3 more points to be scored. MSU could win this game in regulation.
Yeah, I think Michigan State's actually got to slow it down. They've got to play Grand Valley normally is the one that dictates the pace where they slow they've forced Michigan State actually to be the ones that have to speed up to keep up. So Michigan State's got to stay composed, slow it down. They know they're capable, they know they're talented. They're going to put up or shut up this point, you know?
Yeah. We're going to get pizza, by the way.
Nice.
After this game.
Nice.
Yeah, so as we're getting ready to start, you were saying Michigan State needs to slow down. I think that it's not really the speed for Michigan State, but
there are times
when they are very different. There are times when they look lost out there. And right now, with Schuster, the head captain, injured, he's on the sideline. I think that's going to help them a lot because he's their eyes and ears on the sideline. He knows exactly what they're doing wrong. I think that that's one thing that Michigan State is going to be a team that is good at adjusting throughout the game. And it's going to be because they have more experience on their team, not to mention their captain is on the bench.
Thank you.
regular
Let's
season.
Let's go, GV! Talk to each other!
So every team will play every other team at the same time. Five score three.
Who's got it? Got it?
Right now, obviously, they would love to take out two guys. They got rid of good job by Cody Gallagher there to step up. Josh Hill left himself a little bit open, a little bit exposed, but his teammate stepped up to get up to the throw line and scored on the shoe back. So Grand Valley not on the 10 count yet. We got 7 guys left. Michigan State looks like they're they win for the
Bowling Green 2-1.
Akron
beat Bowling Green 3-2.
I like it.
Eyes up,
Britt.
Let's
and
go.
And we have an update here.
Come on, Ben.
Oh,
wow.
And as I was trying to say right before that, Akron defeats Bowling Green in the Ohio tournament 3-2. So, huge win for Akron. Stay back. It's not worth you getting out to try and get that. Two guys team throw like that, Tony. They both threw low, and all Josh Hill had to do was jump. You almost need to communicate ahead of time and make sure that people are trying to different levels. Yeah, good throw there to take out Hill.
It's easy for me to, you know, box and drive, you know, behind the quarterback, but Josh Hill jumps almost every time he goes. Side right now. You have five guys. It's not going to come out at that point.
12 or something. Not that it really matters that much.
You want us to put 6 seconds on it?
Yeah, I mean, four seconds.
All right, so this is going to be 410 officially.
It probably won't matter. 410.
And they're going to play it out. I think we're having a good time earlier. One thing to note, we might be getting a little ahead of us, but if we get to overtime, who replaces Jacob Georges on the OT roster for Michigan State?
I mean,
I got to go with Weakland, right?
I don't understand why he wasn't on overtime last time. He's built for overtime. Brent Weakland's a guy that his best skills are survivability, being able to reset throws in the neutral zone, and getting up and down the court quickly. And, I mean, when it
he
comes
doesn't ever
to
seem to get tired either.
What?
He doesn't ever
he doesn't
seem to
get
tired.
And also, I know he made one bad throw earlier today, but accuracy—he's one of the most accurate throwers on the team. So I think that he's definitely going on the overtime roster if it comes to that. But you just never know. And I got
that or
Jake, update the score here, 2-2.
That or maybe Jake Leko. But let's see what happens. He's four. I think you might see a little bit of a higher pace here for the first minute.
Yeah.
If neither team takes control, we're both going to be content to run it out, and we're going to get some bonus dodgeball here.
Yep. I would say if I had to pick the overtime six for Michigan State, I would put Weakland in. I would put Leko in, Butler, Sullivan as well. Yeah.
I think Jack, first time I've seen him as a freshman last year.
Jack Hill.
He's had a surgery. But he's slacking the mobility, and when you're playing six on six the whole time, you need to be able to get up and down, and I just don't think you have
I think you got to think about pains possibly with the day that you've had.
Great catching so far. But actually, we got him to make more throws than I've seen them do this season at prior tournaments. So.
And now you got 3.5 to go, so it looks like both teams are content with going overtime.
Well, we almost got crossed. The throw just sailed behind him a little bit there. So, down under 3:30 here. About to get some free dodgeball. And, this is what you expect with these two teams. Jack Gerling there, freshman from Michigan State, just kind of almost bait the throw from Captain Josh Hill there. That's why he's trying his best to stop that. Yeah, I think State can tend to go to overtime. Throwing solo throws. I think Michigan State is supremely confident in their top six. Six against your six, come beat us. Oh, Sullivan and Hill, the gamesmanship. You can see Sullivan still taking a throw there, decided he's going to smile, waves.
Ooh!
You don't see that often out of him. Probably not a necessary play at that point, but.
If you had to pick right now, who do you have in this overtime? Assuming we're going to overtime now with 2 minutes left.
Oh, we're going to overtime.
I think athletically, I think State is better.
Oh, wow.
But Grand Valley didn't have much of a problem with them in the overtime 2 weeks ago. And so I got to go with Grand Valley. Their overtime six seemed to play so well together.
Now you gotta take a second. Think about it.
You
can win
seconds.
This point. Skinner gets a ball. You got a minute 5 now. Could it be again? Michigan State making a late push here. This is just like last
game.
Get up to the line. It looks like they're playing from the front line.
Oh, my.
Oh, man.
The Grand Valley is still playing. I mean, good footage, though, you know?
This is good for the stream, good for the viewers. Happy to have y'all here. For those of you just joining us, we're about to get some free dodgeball here.
Overtime again.
10-75 in overtime between these two great teams. Tournament ball is over. They called it. Okay. 6 seconds left. So, theoretically, they could have won. Grand Valley, you call a timeout after 4 seconds. And then.
But is this just like last game? We have this drama right at the end of the point.
It's going to be a weird point. I got to tell you.
Are we going to overtime? No.
Not yet. We're 6 seconds away.
So we're going to try and get a clarification here on what exactly you call.
Yeah, I changed one to say B on accident. How do I fix that?
What?
I messed up the thing to say B.
Okay, they did. They put 10 seconds on the clock. Is that accurate? Can we get a confirmation?
It's 6, Tony.
10 seconds.
I heard them saying 6 down there.
They're having a 6.
And it looks like Joe just went over to the coach and advised.
Is that time accurate?
Like, all the time.
10 seconds.
You probably said something. Listen, you need to call a timeout. They have two timeouts. So you call one at 6, you call one at 2.
And you're just going to drain it. That's one benefit of saving those timeouts. Is now you're just going to limit the clocks.
The last couple minutes of these two teams, when they play, it sort of looks like the last couple minutes of the last game.
Yeah.
Foul, clock stop, timeout, foul. We don't fouls here, but hey, ball's over, stoppage. We're going to call a timeout. We're going to call another one. But anyway, you know, that's a smart play. That half was UCD legend, Jordan Fettel.
We're on the way here. 10 seconds to go.
Stand up. Michigan State's not even going to go.
1, 2,
and I don't even think that the ref granted him timeout.
No, I think Michigan State knew what he was going to do and knew what was going to happen with the clock and said, yeah, forget it.
So Michigan State basically tried to outsmart weeks ago, and both teams have very different overtime losses.
Weakland doing his job. I didn't know he was that fast either. So,
and a quick reset from both teams.
Oh!
strength or even.
No catches, guys!
This ball is over. It's fewer balls, fewer players, same space.
Yeah.
And you know, the problem is not one that
stays going.
Brent Wheatley came up to make a throw, which he had to do. Their clock was getting high. Oh, so they made a throw on Ben Smart, but Ben Smart arguably the best runs him down. That's just going to take out Wheatley. You see Barry Butler step up.
Smart throw! No catches!
Better call a timeout.
I think Kramer stays in. He does. Yeah. I
thought
maybe Josh Hill in,
let's
the
go.
Captain for GVSU, you have Stanko, you have Skinner.
That's all a timeout.
Freeman, Skinner. Instead of that, they have to just go right into it, and they would have had five less seconds to make a throw.
Let's go, Ben!
I believe we have a timeout.
Right,
so we'll let them run back, and then we're off again. Yeah, so another stoppage. It feels like the end of these games with so many stoppages, but it, as you said. Turn into basketball a little bit here. Weakland, last man left for Michigan
Butler
State, trying to pull off an upset against number one in GVSU. Undefeated Grand Valley. They've gone overtime the last two times
because
against Michigan
Butler
State, but their overtime roster has been able to
catch.
Save them. Weakland, if he can make a catch, Evan Barra is the first one in, and it looks like Jack Hilt is number two.
No, Jack Hilt was not in overtime. Number two is Sullivan.
Yeah, he was trying to be a good teammate.
Okay. Rushing the team. We got Saginaw Valley State taking on Central Michigan. Next up on the score, Saginaw Valley, they look good today. They did lose to Michigan State.